Gina Bracco, the principal of Kings Park High School. At this time, we ask you to please stand and join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance, after which we would ask you to remain standing for the singing of our national anthem by the Kings Park High School Chamber Singers under the direction of Mr. Ryan Flatt. So let's begin with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Please remain standing. Our Chief Executive Officer and Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Timothy Egan. Two very, very hardworking assistant superintendents. One, the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum Instruction, Dr. Ralph Fontana. And our Assistant Superintendent for Personnel and Administrative Services, Mr. John Craig. Okay, so we are here today to celebrate yet another Kings Park High School admission into the United States Coast Guard Academy. There has probably been a Kings Parker at the Coast Guard Academy every year since 1961. And four captains and two admirals later, there are five Kings Parker in some type of position at the Academy as of today. Luke Soinas of the graduating class of 2015 will continue that tradition. He is one of 300 from a nationwide pool of approximately 5,000 applicants who undergo a very selective process. So what distinguishes those who are accepted? According to the Coast Guard website, these are the characteristics that they look for in a young man or woman. A proven academic accomplishment, particularly in math and in the sciences. A skill as an athlete. A record of service to the community. Motivation to embrace leadership development. And an unwavering desire to serve their country and humanity. With these requirements, it only makes sense that Luke would be selected. He is an individual who has dedicated his early life to humanitarianism and is committed to helping others. Luke's motto of pro humanitate truly defines who he is as an individual, so devoted to every task and those who are less fortunate. Luke will clearly uphold the law-abiding guiding principles of the Coast Guard and of our nation. My congratulations to Luke Soinas and his family. We here at Kings Park are so all very proud of you. Congratulations. Officers and representatives of the Coast Guard present here today. It's only fitting that coincidentally this happens to be Memorial Day weekend, a time when we as a nation stop to acknowledge the brave men and women of our armed forces. Today we live in a world of evolving threats and unconventional enemies, a world where battlefields often have no boundaries or uniforms. Thank you again for all that you do to keep us safe around the globe. Whether the challenges are to assist those who are in danger at sea, or enforcing our laws by ensuring that contraband stays away from our shores, or policing our waters, protecting them from our enemies, along with pollution and overfishing, or helping to maintain vital ship lanes half a world away, open to commerce. The men and women of the United States Coast Guard meet and far exceed these challenges and make us proud to be an American. Thank you for your sacrifice. Service to the country. Now, the most important part of our little event today, and at this time I'd like to introduce Rear Admiral Sandra Stokes, who will take over the program and tell us a little bit about Luke's accomplishment. Rear Admiral.
Good afternoon, Mr. Egan, Mr. Bracco, Mr. Bishop, staff and faculty, and most of all students, because I know the students are here voluntarily, and May is a really exciting month. You're just back from a vacation and graduation, and the end of the school year is coming up, so thank you all for coming. I also want to make all the welcomes to the distinguished guests that we have on the dais here and the families in the audience. But right now, I would like to recognize Mr. Luke Soinas. That's a tough one. They do that to me on purpose, just to make me a little bit on my toes. And I'd like to call him front center, please. I'm thinking, while you're coming on up, Luke, I'm going to thank your mom, Desiree, I believe, in the audience, and grandma and sister Isabel, y'all down there. Can you raise your hands, family? All right. Luke, I'm going to ask you to kind of shimmy this? Alright. Now, we're front and center, which is what we say in the military. I'd like to talk a little bit about our Coast Guard Academy at the New London, Connecticut. Now, our service academies are well known to most of the students in the audience because you send so many people to the different service academies, and much part thanks to Mr. Leo Ostevo. But right now, we're talking about the Coast Guard Academy. We have a student body in a core of about 1,000, and those are drawn from about 2,500 applications per year. That's fully completed applications, not the 10,000 or so young people who hit our website to see, to inquire. And that's a less than 10% selection rate of the fully qualified people who meet the physical, the leadership, the academic, and the values, core values, requirements of our very, very stringent admissions process. So Luke definitely is one of the small percentage of young men and women in America who have applied for a service academy appointment and gotten accepted. This appointment is, the value is something in the, to the tune of about $400,000 total value for the education here. At the academy, it's a small family feel. It's a, you make friends for life. I think you can see that by looking at the photos that were flashing across the screen of the many Kings Park graduates who have proudly gone to the Coast Guard Academy, and many of whom are still serving as a Coast Guard family, and welcome to that special family, Luke. We're very proud to have you. And at this point in time, I want to present the appointment certificate. And this is the only one I presented this year. Normally, an admissions officer or a Coast Guard Academy partner will come and present these certificates. But I made it my mission this year to come down here because I know this school has produced so many Coast Guard Academy graduates and cadets that I wanted to do this one in person. So I'm going to read this now. This is the United States Coast Guard Academy. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Commandant of the Coast Guard, Luke Soinas is hereby tendered an appointment as a cadet in the United States Coast Guard. This appointment is contingent upon acceptance thereof, qualification in accordance with the standards as defined in the regulations governing appointment and execution of the oath of office. And is signed by me, Admiral Sandra Stowes, on this date. Congratulations. All right, that's great. I'm glad to see Lucas right in my seat. That's a good way to start out as a cadet. I'm glad to. It tells me a lot about your school to hear that applause and see that standing ovation. It tells me that you're a family. So now one might think that we're going to conclude this ceremony today and get y'all back to lunch or whatever is coming up next. But I have one more mission here today. Before I do that mission, though, I forgot to thank those amazing chamber singers. My goodness, let's thank them again. And I have today the qualities and exemplifies the Coast Guard's core values of honor, respect, and devotion to duty. And this devotion to Kings Park and the Coast Guard Academy. So at this time, I'd like to recognize Mr. Leo Ostovo. This is a surprise to Mr. Ostovo. I know he knew I was coming, but he thought I was coming to present Luke's appointment, which I did. But this service across the generation, from Luke to Leo, I call it, is what we're here to present and celebrate now is almost two generations of service to the United States Coast Guard, to America. So what I'm going to do today is present Mr. Leo Ostovo with a public service award. And I'm really thankful that his family's in the audience, his wife Charlotte and his son Tom here, who's already been introduced, and Tom's wife Renee, Tom and Renee's daughter Denali, and Tom and Renee's daughter's friend Taylor. So they're all down here. Will you all please stand up and be recognized too? Those of us who serve know we couldn't do what we did without our families supporting us so that we can do the business of our nation. Ask you to help me on this, Leo. Can you help? You can just hold one side. You can use that cane if you want. Just hold one side. So this is a public service award. Department of Homeland Security, United States Coast Guard, public service combination. Military members, please rise. In recognition of notable services that have assisted greatly in furthering the aims and functions of the Coast Guard, the certificate is awarded to Mr. Leo Ostovo, executed this 26th day of May at the United States Coast Guard Academy and here in Kings Park, signed by me, Admiral Sandra Stoves. United States Coast Guard Public Service Commendation, Mr. Leo Ostovo. Mr. Leo Ostovo is cited for exceptional public service as a leader in Military Academy and Reserve Officer Training Corps, recruiting from 1970 to 2015. Mr. Ostovo has excelled in service as a high school teacher, varsity coach, counselor, and mentor in the Kings Park Public School District, and as a public leader in the on Long Island, New York, for almost 50 years. During this time, he personally inspired hundreds of high school students toward service in the armed forces and toward a college degree. Mr. Ostovo's commitment to leadership and recruiting has been instrumental in developing two generations of Coast Guard leaders. As a result of Mr. Ostovo's efforts, over 150 high school students successfully obtained a Military Service Academy appointment, and 110 students earned ROTC scholarships. Out of the Service Academy appointments, 24 of those students received appointments to the U.S. Coast Guard Academy. He has also been instrumental in the Academy achieving its diversity goals, with 27% of his applicants being women and minorities, and or minorities. Mr. Ostovo's commitment to leadership development did not stop at recruiting. And this is a certificate to accompany that flag, and... So, right now, I'd like to ask, actually, Admiral Tom Ostevo to make a few remarks, and then we're going to ask Mr. Leo Ostevo to make a few remarks.
Boy, thanks, Andy. Thanks, everybody, for showing up. You know, it is actually a really special day in a lot of ways. Obviously, I started here, same as you, well, Luke, and in 1977, headed for the Coast Guard Academy. Then Dean Blau was my roommate as a fourth class cadet, so when you get to the Coast Guard Academy, those people you meet become lifelong friends, and don't forget that. It's also great to have Jack and Mary here, great friends of ours, and served as my chief of staff when I was up in Alaska for the last several years, and a great American, and looking forward to seeing you with some stars at some point here. Yeah, so thanks for coming. And Bob was always saying he was also a retired Coast Guard member and a veteran and somebody with a long history in the Coast Guard. So thanks everybody for being here. Yeah, it's great. This is I'm coming up on retirement after all these years, 34 years back in duty and 38 years since I went to the Academy. And the reins over to Sandy, she comes down to Coast Guard headquarters and leaves the Coast Guard Academy. So I couldn't think of a more fitting way to actually put on my uniform for the very last time than to be here with Dad. So.
In that, dating back to 1960, we have continued to place students not only at the Coast Guard Academy, but at academies around the country, and that speaks volumes for this community and this student body and this high school, which is absolutely, absolutely amazing. That is a huge piece of data. And when you talk about huge pieces of data, it was mentioned earlier, but you cannot underemphasize, and it's hard to put a monetary value on education, but you cannot underemphasize the monetary value of this appointment for Luke and his family. It has an approximate value of hundreds of thousands of dollars. I think the $400,000 was the amount that was mentioned earlier. If you think about it, essentially Luke has a full ride to college, which is absolutely incredible. So with that being said, I just again want to congratulate Luke and his family. Thank you to the Coast Guard for your amazing partnership, you know, dating back over the years, and especially to Mr. Osipo. I know we have to trick him into honoring him at these events because he hates being honored, but no one loves Kings Park like Mr. Osipo. We appreciate everything you've done. Coming out of this warm afternoon to honor Luke and Mr. Osipo.